11 corners on this 3.6-mile track, with seven of those coming in the form of chicanes. And with a good slipstream and DRS open, there should be plenty of opportunity for some passing here today. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the races. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way you approach those roles?
Interesting question, Crofty. They're two very different mindsets. I mean, when I tested for BAR, we had full in-season testing where, per driver, you'd cover up to 15,000 kilometres per season. And in that role, it was more about working for the team, trying to help them improve the car and drive as systematically as you could, so that that data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When you're lining up on the grid for a race, however, your frame of mind's all about what you can get out of the situation on that day, and the car's the tool to help you achieve what you want. You still want to focus on setup, of course, but it's more about the here and now, getting yourself as far up the field as possible, and less about development work for the future.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. An immense...
You can run side by side into the retifilio, but don't brake too late on these cold tyres or you will hit someone.
Thank you.
race so far. Safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Exit now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. to the car behind is 6.9 seconds. Thank you. laps of fuel remaining. Hard for that one. Congratulations.
Here's our winner, pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And as we can see, it's time for the podium. And as the drivers make their way out, there's a familiar red suit making its way to the top step. Fantastic win for Ferrari. Forget pit stop.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Strong start. Well done. 9.0 seconds.
And an incredible win for Force India. A brilliant performance. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
I can see them on their way out to the podium now. Force India have really come a long, long way in this sport. And what a special race this was to see them earn that top spot.